Hey, nice to see you again here at my new video. I'm on Java right now, and this night we will go to the Mount Ujen. This is a beautiful volcano and a very famous one here in Indonesia. And tomorrow night we will also go to the Mount Bromo. This is even more famous, and I think this is even more nicer. To the Mount Ujen I've already been last year. It was very nice because you can see blue flames coming out of the volcano in the night. This is awesome, and also sunrise is nice, but for the sunrise you have to go a bit up, but yeah, you will see that later. And the Mount Bromo, I just saw it until now on pictures, and it looks so incredible, like you're on Mars or something, so definitely another world, and I'm very excited for that. Yeah, and so far today, I first needed to drive to Kuta to go to the travel shop, because from there the car started, so it was around 30 minutes drive with a Gojek to there. And yeah, then we started from there. It took us, I think, around 4 hours or something to go to the ferry port, and then 1 hour with a ferry and driving around here a bit. So all together around 6 hours of drive until we arrived at our hotel. We will stay here until midnight, and then we will go to the volcano, so our driver picks us up and brings us there. Tour is pretty nice. I will leave the link to the tour company in the description, because it's more like they only arrange the transport and you can choose your accommodation and stuff for yourself. So it's far less expensive than other tours. So other tours, it's like around 5 to 6 million. I even saw tours for 9 million or more. So that's very much money. And it's in rupiah, of course, not in dollars or euro or something. So 4.5 million would be around 300 euro. And now I paid around 90,000 for the tour. No, not 90, 900,000 for the tour. And so it's a lot cheaper, like what is it, like around 60 euro only. It's just for the transport, that's good. But yeah, of course we go with a group. It's not like I'm doing the trip on my own, but there's enough time to film everything. I cannot film much in the night because the lightning conditions are not good. So 12 o'clock now, let's go. So just want to leave here a bit about the way up and down to the Mount Ujen, and it's actually a bit shorter than I remembered. Maybe that was because last year we were with a group that was a bit lazier, I would say, so definitely took longer last year. But this year I would say for going up it was between 1.5 or 2 hours, and just there's like a half of that around is the hard part, so where it's pretty steep, and so where it's quite steep and your legs get too hurt and stuff. So but this is only around, I think it can be done in 30 or 40 minutes if you're trained a bit, otherwise it takes a bit longer. I think it took me maybe 50 or 60. And yeah, then when you arrive at the crater, then of course you have to go down also, and this takes between 20 and 30 minutes, depends how much people are in front of you. And when you go up again, it's around 30 minutes, I would say. And yeah, it's definitely worse to go down. Like last year we were thinking of going down or not, but you should definitely do it just because of the blue flames. It looks amazing. I actually didn't saw the lake this year because there was just too much fog there, and I don't want to go there like when it's dark, like
I mean, I cannot see much when it's dark, right? So I wouldn't go there then. And yeah, so for going down, it definitely took less than an hour now, and I was filming in between, so it's pretty fast. It can be done in maybe 30 to 40 minutes. Took me maybe 15 all around, it's because I was filming. And yeah, so it's actually pretty easy to go to Ijen. Of course, it challenges a bit sometimes when it goes steep, but it's definitely a very easy track that anyone can do. So even if you're a beginner and if it's your first track and you're not trained well or something, you can definitely do it. And if it's much too hard for you, then you can grab those taxis here. Those are the workers here that pull up all the sulfur from the volcano, and they carry all their vehicles with them, and they offer tourists to pull them up. And yeah, so then you go there pretty easily, but it costs around 350,000. I mean, for that kind of work, it's really not much, and I wouldn't do it because I don't want to do that to the people. It's like really like a slave or something. I don't like that. And yeah, also regarding the people, it's one of the hardest jobs in the world, actually. They die with around 40 or 45 because they don't even wear gas masks, so they get all the sulfur inside their lungs and stuff. It's also not good. And they carry up to 80 kilograms on their shoulders. So it's a very hard job there. And that's why I would recommend anyone to buy some souvenirs there from them. It's really not that expensive. I bought some sulfur stuff now for 50,000, so it's definitely not much money for you, but over the months when they sell enough to some tourists, then it makes a lot of difference for them, because they only earn around 300 euro per month, which is good money in Indonesia maybe. But for this kind of job, it's definitely better if they earn a bit more. So here's one of the few places that I would say give something for, spend some money for souvenirs, simply because they do such a hard job and they earned it. Yeah, like some street sellers in Kuta or something, just I wouldn't buy there anything. Good morning, we had a beautiful sunrise and we were at the sunrise point. I don't know the name anymore, it's quite difficult. And yeah, I will just display it here in the picture so you know where it was. And the sunrise was awesome because it's like we were between the clouds, like the lower clouds were under us and the higher clouds were above us, and so I did a very nice time lapse there. I loved it, and I just saw it on the smaller picture now on the camera. But it looks like that the lower clouds are moving in a different direction than the upper clouds. So that was definitely amazing. And also when you watch to the other side of the sunset, you see two volcanoes standing there. I think it's the Bromo here and the other one. I don't know if it's a volcano or just a mountain, but it looks incredible. It's like another planet here. All the surroundings are awesome. And yeah, so then when the sun goes up, the light goes through these volcanoes and it looks incredible. So this is definitely a very nice viewpoint for the sunrise. I can recommend that to anyone to go there instead of going directly to the Bromo. And yeah, now I'm here in front of the Bromo. I can see it right now here. And we will grab a horse now to ride there. I mean, you can't walk. It should take maybe, if you go up, maybe 20 or 30 minutes. I think maybe longer, I'm not sure. I think I read 45, but when I see that now, it doesn't look that far. But I think when I'm here, I want to enjoy this horse ride and going there like that. Yeah, so we'll do that now. Get a horse, I don't know what it costs now, but we'll see. And yeah, then let's take some awesome shots from the amazing Bromo. till now had a refreshing shower, and yeah, I mean, this trip was amazing. The Mount Bromo is the most incredible volcano I've ever seen so far, and I've seen a lot of volcanoes in the past two years, even if I didn't climb any of those volcanoes or much of those volcanoes. Just the Ijen, the Mount Agung, and one volcano on the Grafoss or something on Iceland. But yeah, Bromo is just, it's amazing. And yeah, it's beautiful for sunrise, but also like when you see inside this crater, it's so nice because it feels active because it's so loud, like brrr. So the Bromo is definitely angry, yeah. But this makes it even more awesome. I just loved it. And yeah, I would actually recommend, especially for photographers and for videographers, to stay here a bit longer, because just the Bromo is just 10 minutes around from my hotel. It's so easy to go there. Like when you want to go to the crater and not up the hill to film the sunrise or something, it takes a bit longer. But also here, like the villages and so on, this all looks so amazing. It's so photogenic. And yeah, like yesterday we went here of around 3:30, and there the sun was already in a position where it went inside here. It was shining inside here in a very good angle, so it hit the hills and stuff, and that looks incredible. Like I think if you a professional photographer or videographer, like for landscapes, then it's definitely a good place to stay here a bit longer. Yeah, this area is just amazing for that. Yeah, especially the volcano. So now I will take a short breakfast and then go back to Bali. It's actually an 8 to 9 hour drive. It's crazy long. Yeah, I would, maybe it's better to take or tell the driver to bring you to Surabaya, because there you can take a flight to Bali or everywhere else, depending on what your travel plans are. So that could potentially be a better option. I mean, like 8 or 9 hours drive, I don't really want to do that now, but it's also good because I can review all the footage from the weekend, and after that I can maybe start cutting it, yeah. So see you in the next video, guys. It was nice to see you here. Next week I will go to Thailand for 5 days. I'm not sure if I do a video there. I have to see, depending on how much work I have and how much time. But after that, going to Germany for 2 weeks, I think, or a bit less. And yeah, after that, everything is open. Maybe back to Bali, maybe the Canaries. I'm not sure yet, but see you.